Hello students, unit 5 is about the tiger's claw. In that activity 1, imagine the following situation. Write down what you would do. Share your points with your teacher and classmates. We could together think about these pictures. In first picture, you can see that there is a snake. If you watch this snake in the garden where you are sitting on a bench, what will you do? Either you will shout loudly, or if you are having a good mind, presence of mind, then what you will do, you will call to someone. If you have the number of snake catcher or like that, either you run away from the place. Then the second situation is showing a mouse. You are bending and looking under the bed, helping your grandmother, father, find its sandal. This is what jumps over your hand. And what you will do? You will throw that chappals or slippers, whatever you are holding in your hand, and you will run away from there, or you will keep hold of a stick and you will make him run away from there. So that can be the two situations, right students? The third one is you are washing your hands. Suddenly a large number of cockroaches came out of the drain, and what you will do? Yeah, it's really the very annoying experience. First thing, you will be angry over that, you will run away from there, or you will call your mother out, that mother, what happened, just check, and you will draw that cockroach lines or something like that, chalk, which can help you in that case. You are alone at home, you hear the door crack and see him. Then what you will do? You will try to find out who is there, or either you will be under your blanket, or you will sleep tightly so no one could disturb you. So these are the two situations you can handle. So we have discussed with these four situations how you will tackle. The tiger's claw is actually a very nice lesson. It's written over here is part one. In part one you could see that, and the part two is here. Okay, the part one is about the narrator. The narrator is actually a person who is working in a company. One day when he came to a new place, what happens over there? That is a tiger sentry at his resting room, or you can say that a room where he was staying. What happened at that time? That is narrated over here in the lesson, the tiger's claw. Actually, the tiger's claw means the pointed nails are there, and that hand or the holding part of the body of tiger is called as a claw here, over here, which is having long sharp nails. Okay, so I opened my eyes and saw at the door a tiger pushing himself. Now this is the narrator who is talking to us. He is working in a firm where it is meant for the fertilizer company. Okay. It was a muddled moment, confusing, a disturbing at that situation can be said as moment for me, not being sure whether the dream was continuing or whether I was awake. It may be the early morning, it may be the midnight, but he was very much confused. What's happening over here? अगर आपको भी आधी रात में कभी कोई fearful, डरावना सपना आता है और आप sudden जाग जाते हो तो you couldn't understand. Is it morning or a fearful night? Dreadful dream. So that same is happening over here. I at first thought it was my friend. Who was it? The station master who was coming in. But my dream had fully prepared my mind. Means at that time, he must be sharing the room with the station master who was supposed to come at that point, come at that time. So he was thinking that he must have returned. I saw the thing clearly against the starlit sky. What I was watching again, the starlit means the night or the sky that was shining with the stars' brightness. Tail wagging, growling, and above all, his terrible eyes gleaming through the dark. What's happening now? The eyes were gleaming, shining he was, and the tiger was wagging and growling and making noises. I understood the fertilizer company would have to manage without my lecture from the following day. He was actually came there for his lectures, and that lectures he has to give was for his fertilizer company. Now he's saying that maybe I think the fertilizer company would have to manage without my lecture because it seems that this tiger is going to eat me. Isn't it a fearful experience at the same time a funny experience? Would I have to manage without my lectures from the following day? The tiger himself, rather startled by the noise of the chair and stood hesitating. He started making noise of the chair, or maybe he started to going back at the chair. Who? The narrator, and that is the voice which hesitated, the tiger. He saw me quite clearly in my corner. Who? The tiger. He saw me quite clearly in my corner. Wherever he was standing, he kept holding himself in a corner, and he seemed to be telling himself, my dinner is there ready, but let me first know what is clattering noise is about. You could find out that the person over here is a narrator who is very funnily explaining his experience, though in a fearful condition. You could imagine, just imagine, if a tiger is in front of you and you are talking in a very funny way like this. The person is talking to us, that tiger is thinking, my dinner is ready. Who is the dinner over here? Of course, the wild animals can eat the human beings, and it could be the dinner of that tiger, and the tiger is going to eat the narrator. But he is talking very plainly that he is trying to find out the clattering noise. What is it about? Somehow wild animals are less afraid of beings than they are of pieces of furniture like chairs and tables. Means they will not fear about such things, wild animals, right? I have seen circus men managing a whole menagerie with nothing more than a chair. Means you must have seen that circus mein jo animals hote hai, to wo chair ke sath kai sare stunt karte hai. Jaise chair idhar se udhar ghumana, wo tiger ke upar se ghuma kar use uske samne waise rakhna, us pe baith jana, ya fir wo tiger wagera ko ek hunter lekar char pair ko ek hi place pe rakh kar उसको खड़ा करना. These all sorts of thing we must have or you must have seen in circus with nothing more than a chair. They are doing that work on the chair. God gives us such recollections in order to save us at critical moments. Actually now narrator is talking to us that ये जो recollection मैं कर रहा हूँ means whatever memories I am having right now. The narrator here is explaining his condition to us. God gives us such recollections in order to save us at critical moments. And as the tiger stood observing me and watching the chair, I put out my hands and we disappeared. Means in that condition, he tried to stretch through the table towards me. Means he was standing near the chair and he was just talking, the narrator, that God has given us the strength of recollecting everything just because to help ourselves here. And also the stool, I sat with my back to the corner, the table waist, means it was like in a triangle shape making with the corner, and that way it waist in nicely with the corner. I sat under it and the stool walled up another side. While I dragged the table down, a lot of things fell off it. A table lamp, a long knife and pins. Means whatever is there on the table, that everything started falling down. From my shelter, I peeped at the tiger. Shelter means he was covering his head, the body under or beside the table, and that way he started to peep at the tiger, who was also watching me with interest. Means at the same time, tiger was also watching to the narrator. I peeped means to take the head out of that protected area of the table. And what happened further over there? From the shelter, I peeped at the tiger, who was also watching me at interest. Evidently, he didn't like his meal to be so completely shut out of sight. Means evidently means there was very ideally he don't like the food which is completely hidden. Who is the food here? The food is the narrator here. So he cautiously advised a step or advanced a step or two, making a sort of rumbling noise in his throat, which seemed to shake up the little station house. My end was nearing. Now he could understand the narrator that my end was nearing. And what he did, the tiger cautiously advanced means came further one step or two, making the rumbling noise in his throat, which seemed to shake up the little station, means little station house, whatever. He is trying to put his head, the body, around the table and the chair behind it. So he called it as the small station of hiding there. My end was nearing. Now he could find out that the tiger is coming near to him. So he is calling it as my end was nearing. I really pitied the woman whose lot it was to have become my wife. Now he is thinking about his wife at the same time. And he is saying that I was really feeling pity about her. That how she will survive without me. Here the lady he calls to his wife. Okay. Now the part 3. I held up the chair like a shield and flourished it. Means like a shield he kept further in front of his body the chair. And he started to push it. Means the chair. And the tiger hesitated and fell back a step or two. That way when he started moving, the tiger also started hesitating a step back, one step or two step. Now once again, we spent some time, means together they were spending the time now. Just he is coming forward, the tiger is moving back, and that way it everything is going up. Watching each other's movements, I held my breath and waited. Of course, though he is narrating the story, he was very in a fearful air, a condition which is really threatening, and that way he was holding his breath and waited. When you are in a fearful condition, you won't feel free, and that is why or the way you are holding your breath is like waiting for the next, what is happening next. That is the curious point over here. The tiger stood here fiercely waving its tail. The tiger is waving the tail continuously. Fiercely means as though he is not now at all worried about. Which sometimes struck the side walls and sent forth a thud. He suddenly crouched down without taking his eyes off me and scratched the floor. You must have seen the cat or the tiger having the habit of scratching the floor with the nails like this. They will do like this. And that way he did. Suddenly crouched down without taking his eyes off me and scratched the floor with his claws. He sharpening them for me, as it seems that he was sharpening his claws, means making it sharp to eat me or to attack me. I told myself the little shack had already acquired the smell of a zoo. It made me sick, means when I went near to that animal, it gave me a smell of the zoo. Wild animals has that smell, like zoo where the wild animals are kept. It made me sick. The tiger kept scratching the floor with his forepaws. It was the most hideous sound you could think of. And that was the most hideous sound. Okay. Hideous here means you can say that the sound which is confused, bewildered, or a sound which is really fearful right now to the narrator. So this is the story of your part one, and it ended with the condition of the narrator. Now what happens in the next story that I will tell you in the next part of the same lesson. So keep waiting, and I am going to share with you that shortly. That is your activity 5.